When it comes to understanding the creative power of blending modes, it becomes a valuable tool opening up new possibilities for your editing process. Let's break down a simplified version of the mechanics of how each blending mode operates by discussing four main components: subtractive, additive, complex, and difference. Let's first start with the subtractive category. Each of these blending modes' primary function makes white pixels transparent while preserving black pixels. Watch when we blend these two layers with each other when we select the blending mode Multiply. As it subtracts the white pixels, it keeps the black pixels intact, which will be especially helpful for matte overlays, borders, title masks, and more. Now, unlike the subtractive blending modes, the additive category functions the opposite way, which instead makes the black pixels transparent and keeps the white pixels in place. If we select screen as our blending mode, all the black pixels now vanish, while the white pixels are now projected onto the bottom layer, which opens up opportunities to create some unique visuals with elements like film burns, dust and scratches, CRT overlays, and more. Next, we have the complex category. Essentially, these blending modes mainly render gray pixels transparent. More specifically, the closer a gray pixel is to being a true achromatic gray, or in other words, exactly between black and white, the more transparent it becomes. To demonstrate, let's use this film overlay from my 8mm film grain pack. By selecting the hard light blending mode, it eliminates all the gray pixels while preserving that crispy film texture as a nice overlay for your footage. Lastly, with the blending modes difference, exclusion, subtract and divide, their functions generally operate on the difference of color values between pixels. Watch when we stack one visualizer on top of the other and select difference. All the white pixels become inverted to black, or when we apply one of our punch hole transitions, creating a trippy visual experience. And that concludes the summary of how blending modes function in any editing software. For more editing resources, be sure to check out my other editing packs, including my all-access deal where you can bundle and save 75% off my entire editing asset library, giving you the creative tools needed to help elevate your workflow. I'll provide a link at the top of the description. Otherwise, edit smart and stay sharp. Peace.